Hey everyone, it's Angie and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to be painting scenes from Studio Ghibli movies. I've seen a few other artists recreate their favorite movie scenes from Studio Ghibli, and as a fan, I couldn't resist. If you haven't seen a Studio Ghibli movie, then I highly recommend you stop and watch one right now. They are so good, with the storytelling and the art is just breathtaking. My favorite of all time is Laputa Castle in the Sky. I stumbled upon it a long, long time ago on my mom's computer while surfing for movies to watch and fell in love. If you haven't guessed it already, that's the first scene I'll be painting. I was a bit hesitant because it was so detailed and I wasn't sure I could paint it. Well, all Studio Ghibli movies are super detailed, and so making this was really hard in every way. But I tried to pick the scenes with as little detail and easy perspective, and even so, this first scene was complicated. The sky was pretty easy, obviously, but the city was the hard part, and it was because it was so small on the page, too. I'm sure the illustrators for Studio Ghibli use really big paper and computers to make every detail. So when I realized this was going to be hard doing all the little details, I tried to focus on the values and the shadows of the city instead, and that helped me a lot. But also throughout this painting, I had to keep changing colors and mixing a lot, and putting down every single stroke was kind of a lot of pressure. And I think it was mostly due to the fact that it felt like my painting had to be in par with the reference, but I got through it. I looked at the reference a ton to make sure it resembled the city and was recognizable. I started with light washes of watercolor so I could visualize the tones and set them in the right places. But when I started using the gouache, it got a bit harder because it started to cover the sketch layer by layer. And I couldn't see what went where, and that also made me question where I was going to put my next stroke. And this made me realize how much I depend on line art for my art, which isn't necessarily a bad thing. I've seen and heard a lot of artists practice with just a pen to sketch and make their art without doing pencil first. And to me, that is so daunting because I wouldn't be able to erase, and I erase a ton. And that's also one of the reasons why I don't show my sketching process in these videos, because they just take way too long. I'm always erasing. But anyway, I was kind of doing the same thing with not having made a sketch just with paint, and more towards the end of my process. But that challenge also made the result more interesting and more satisfying when I reached the end of the piece. I've been using the Hime gouache for about a week so far, and it's been difficult to be honest, but every medium has a learning curve. It's been incredibly fun though, and every time I look at the set, I just want to start experimenting and painting with them. The only thing I wish that came with the set is that it showed the light fastness of the pigments, because then I could know if I could use them for a bigger project and could result in selling my artwork and stuff like that. But it's also fine with me because I'm just experimenting and learning about gouache. The second painting I made is from Spirited Away. It was honestly one of the only other scenes I found that didn't have too much stuff going on. But I quickly realized that The hard part of this painting was getting the yellow, orange, and the purples and blues not to mix together and become really muddy. Luckily, I could layer the gouache enough for it to look good. Again, I started with a light wash of watercolor. I've noticed that with watercolors, I can get a really even wash of color with a bit more control compared to watering down the Hemi paint and using that. So, to be honest, I've only watched Spirited Away once, and it was a long time ago with my mom, and it was kind of confusing for me. And it never really has been one of those movies that resonated with me too much. I never understood why it was so popular and why everyone was so obsessed with it. So while I was painting this, I wanted to watch the movie again, so that's definitely going to be on my to-do list soon. I do like the art style and the storytelling, of course, and the creativity of Spirited Away is so pretty. I've basically seen almost every Studio Ghibli movie, and I do love them all, especially Kiki's Delivery Service and The Secret World of Arrietty. Some though are really sad, but they're still really good quality movies. I posted on my Instagram story a list of all of them and the ones that I've seen. So check that out if you want. I'll leave a link in the description as always. Towards the end of these paintings, I didn't really know when to call them finished. I wanted them to look exact and like the reference, but it wasn't supposed to be like some grand finished piece, so I had to stop myself and actually call it done. There wasn't much I could add towards the end anyway, and all the layers of gouache that had to be added were added. I finished them off with some color pencils to add to the really tiny details I couldn't get with my brushes. I thought of using micron pens too, but I didn't want the lines to be too harsh. The little doors in the city and the clothesline next to the house were their hardest to create with gouache. And I'm so glad I used my color pencils for it. I also used my white gel pen for a few highlights. I love the results that came with these scenes, especially since I love Studio Ghibli so much. It's always inspired me to create my art. It's kind of like having a bit of Studio Ghibli with me through these little paintings. And it also made me see how much hard work could come from making these scenes. I hope you guys liked watching this process as much as I loved painting these. And if you haven't seen the movies, go ahead, they are so amazing. And if you have seen them, tell me which ones are your favorite. Until next time guys, take care. Bye!